Hello, my friends, and welcome back. Thank you very much for being with me again today. Interesting article involving Mexico and United States of America and money, lots of money. So can you guess what happened? It happened what always happened, and which is I buy your allegiance, your support with money. Let's see. This article comes from Reuters from today, July 13th, 2022. This is the title. Mexico sees $40 billion in US investment through 2024 amid business talks. So we have here two guys. We got President Andrés Manuel López Obrador of Mexico, and we have Joseph Biden. All right, so let's see. Washington. U.S. companies plan to invest $40 billion in Mexico between now and 2024. Mexican President Andrés Manuel López Obrador told a meeting of U.S. and Mexican executives on Wednesday. According to Mexican Foreign Ministry Marcelo Ebrard, López Obrador and Ebrard are in Washington after a meeting between the Mexican president and his U.S. counterpart Joe Biden, as well as other officials, on Tuesday. Calling it great news for Mexico, Ebrard revealed the prospective investments on Twitter as Mexican officials met the executives for a business breakfast in the U.S. capital. Mexican officials said the talks could deliver progress on a raft of pending investments in Mexico by U.S. energy companies. Billions of dollars in foreign investment in Mexico have been held up by disputes between companies and the government as López Obrador tightens state control over the energy market. Still, López Obrador on Tuesday told Biden that Mexico was ready to work with the United States to help secure energy supplies and promote the economic integration of North America. The U.S. ambassador to Mexico, Ken Salazar, said in June that Mexico and the United States are working through disputes involving U.S. companies worth some $30 billion. So what do you take out of this? Well, let's just talk about what happened in the past, I don't know, 2 months or so. Mexico did not really say much about Russia's special operation in Ukraine, which angered the United States. Then it said that it will not participate in the Summit of Americas. At least the president will send an official over there. Then it also spoke about making some deals with Russia, and then supporting, you know, Cuba and Venezuela and you know, the other country in Central America who were not invited to the Summit of Americas. He made some other comments regarding it seems like I remember it was a Jewish reporter or something, and that always creates problems. But he stood by his statements because he was just he used logic, and he said, no, this is what I said, and I stand by it. And everybody kissed his butt. Oh, anyway, it's not about that. So he, this Obrador president, presidente, he showed a little bit of balls, to say the least, and now those balls have to be cut off because they grow too big, and when some balls grow too big, other people might see it and might want to grow big balls as well. So they will set an example by cutting them off with bribes, meaning investments in Mexico, promised investments. So it's not something based on logic and ideology or debate. It's simply, you know, thuggish. You want your operation to be running? Okay, then you do what I say, and as a reward, I'm going to give you some money. All right, that's basically how it comes here with the US political system. You make the biggest contribution, then you demand. You call the elected representative after the election, say, good luck. Now, this is my direct line to you. And we start demanding. But you don't have to start demanding because the elected officials know exactly what, why they were elected there and for the people. Okay, some people, yes. So, Obrador got the investments. He had a big mouth. He got it. Now, I don't know, as I said before, there are some, it's a fight of, how should I put it nicely? I will put it straight, briberies. It's a fight between these guys bribing these guys and other guys bribing the same guy. And who got the biggest bribes wins the allegiance of that country and the support. In this case, could be China versus the United States, who makes the investments bigger or the help will get the support and, as I said, allegiance of that country. In this case, United States definitely wants Mexico by its side because Mexico is really by its side. And if Mexico goes a different route, then United States is very, very much exposed to some deployment of foreign weapons, if you know what I mean, or personnel and whatever, what else. So you don't want the Chinese or the Russians right there. And it's going to be for you too late to do anything. So yeah, it's always good to have good neighbors. Only Romanians think that those neighbors from 7,000 kilometers away from their country are better than the neighbors from, I don't know, 300 miles. But it's not the Romanians, but Romanians were indoctrinated. I bring that up because it's always, you know, I have a very, how should I put it, sour taste in my heart about how Romania is led and is owned by the big club. And sometimes it's good, but sometimes it's not good. And it's unfortunate that you are required to to be either or instead of having no. Like for instance, Turkey. Turkey is with all sides. It's a, opportunistic country, as is Saudi Arabia, as is India, and other smart countries that could play an independent role on this planet. But Romania, you know, is just, anyway, it's not about Romania here, it's about Mexico. And I hope those investments will come. And once they come, remember, they could be withdrawn. So once they come in and everything goes well, that means you can be blackmailed. So the same thing as with those, the pipelines, remember, the Nord Stream 2, leaving yourself to be blackmailed by Russia. Remember Trump when said, if you get gas from Russia, Russia can blackmail you. Well, what if you make some investments here with American companies? You can withdraw your investments whenever you want, and then your country is going to go poor or poorer overnight or in a month. But it's okay, you know. You do what you can do. I guess the best way is to be self-reliant. And not many countries are, unfortunately. And if you try to be, they will take care of you and put the IMF on you and the World Bank to help you a little bit. Thank you very much for being with me again today. Stay strong, stay smart, look for the truth, and be just.